know you were here. I'm happy to see you, because maybe you can guess where I'm going. I'm going somewhere here on Sesame Street, and I'm going there now. I'll give you a hint. It's a store. Store right here on Sesame Street. Another hint. Alan works there. Now can you guess where it is? Well, it's right here. Hooper's store. Come on, let's go. Hi, Alan. One birdseed milkshake the way you always make it.
You mean with birdseed?
Right. Gee, you sure know what I like, Alan. Alan? What's that you're doing?
Oh, I'm just practicing a little hula dance for my trip to Hawaii.
Oh, you're going to Hawaii? Oh, boy.
Yep. I am taking a little vacation, Big Bird.
Wow, a vacation. That sounds great. Sounds awesome. That sounds like a terrible idea.
What do you mean?
Well, if you're not here, I won't be able to get my birdseed milkshake the way you always make it.
Oh, don't worry, Big Bird. I've got it all planned out.
You do?
Yep. I put an ad in today's paper looking for somebody to run the store while I'm gone. You see? Right here. It says, help wanted. Looking for someone to run Hooper's store for 1 week. Must be able to cook. Knowledge of the alphabet a plus. If interested, please come see Alan today.
Oh, well, did anyone come in for the job yet?
Not yet.
Well then, Alan, maybe you should just cancel your trip and just stay here like you always do.
We come about the job.
I guess I spoke too soon.
I'm the butcher.
I am the baker.
And I'm the candlestick maker.
Gosh, 3 men in a tub?
That's nice, but I don't need a butcher, a baker, or a candlestick maker.
What are you talking about? It says so right here in the ad. Good luck, read it for yourself.
Rub-a-dub-dub, need 3 men in a tub. And what kind of men should they be? Why, a butcher, a baker, a candlestick maker. We're looking to hire all 3.
See? Yep. Says so right in the ad.
Yeah. It's not my ad.
You mean this isn't beef sticks, breadsticks, and candlesticks?
No, this is Hooper's.
Oh, I'm so sorry. We have the wrong place. Come on, boys, let's go.
My mistake.
Yeah, our bad.
Told you it was the wrong address.
You know, you're really starting to rub-a-dub-dub me the wrong way.
Too bad it didn't work out, Alan. Now I guess you'll just have to stay here like you always do. And nothing has to change.
Oh, I'm not giving up yet, Big Bird. Oh, look, here comes somebody else.
Hey.
Hi, you must be here about the job.
Actually, I just came for a glass of pineapple juice.
Oh, boy. Did you hear that, Alan? She just wants pineapple juice.
Yep, 1 pineapple juice coming right up.
So, seems like you're never going to find someone to take your place, Alan.
Maybe you're right, Big Bird.
So, why don't you just cancel your trip, stay right here on Sesame Street, just like you always do,
Have no fear! The Master Chef is here!
Oh, no.
Oh, yes! I studied for years in Europe.
Really? Where?
Tuscany! Get it? Tusk of an elephant, Tuscany! I love that joke! I'm really cooking now!
Speaking of cooking, what exactly can you cook?
Why tell you when I can show you? Stand back as I prepare my world-famous omelet. I call it Rhapsody in Blue Cheese. Oh, boy, I love to cook.
Careful,
the Master Chef needs a frying pan. Yes. Wait, no. Oh, first the Master Chef needs an egg. No, wait. What comes first, the frying pan or the egg? Why are you all watching? This is making me so very nervous.
Excuse me, Mr. Elephant.
Oh, that's Chef Elephant.
Sorry, Chef Elephant. Hi, I'm Natalie, and I couldn't help but notice you seem a bit nervous.
Me? Nervous? Don't be ridiculous. I'm terrified.
You can make an omelet. Just calm down.
Okay.
Take a deep breath.
I'm breathing.
And count to 5.
1, 2, 3. three, four, five.
And you can do it.
No.
You can get through it.
Really?
First you take an egg and you break it.
Break it, break it.
Stir in some milk, that's how you make it.
Make it, make it.
Now you take your pan and heat it up hot.
Hot, 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 hot.
Butter it up and pour the eggs in the spot.
Spot, 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 spot.
Now's the part where you add the cheese.
Cheese, 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 cheese.
And fold it over nice, just as easy as you please.
Please, 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 please.
Just keep your cool and you're gonna roll. Cause you can do it.
Oh, boy. I can do it. I can really do it.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna go work for Peanuts.
Huh?
Oh, Peanuts is the fanciest elephant restaurant in town. I never thought I was good enough to work there, but now I know I can do it. I can do it.
Sorry about that.
Well, gonna cancel your trip now, Alan?
Well, there's no need, Big Bird. I found somebody perfect for the job.
Ooh.
Excuse me, Natalie, but how would you like to work here?
Me?
Sure, you're a natural.
I don't know.
Oh, listen, it would only be for a week while I'm on vacation.
You know, I have worked as a waitress, but never at a place like Hooper's before.
Looks like she can't do it, Alan. Right, Natalie?
It does seem like an interesting place to work.
Oh, yeah, and you'll meet all kinds of new people and birds and monsters and honkers and dingers and even snuffleupaguses. Listen, why don't you give it a try, see if you like it?
All right. I'll give it a try.
Great. All right. I'm going to go finish packing, and I will be back in a little while. Oh, but if you need me, here is my number. There you go. All right. Have fun.
Bye, Alan.
Bye, Big Bird.
Bye.
What's wrong?
Well, this is different.
I know. It's new, but it's very exciting.
Yeah, I guess.
Oh, a customer.
I'll have the usual, Alan.
What's the usual?
Not you, that's for sure. You're not Alan.
I know. I'm Natalie. I'm filling in for Alan.
Wait a minute. Nobody can just, like, fill in for Alan. He's Alan. He's irreplaceable.
I know. But Alan's going on vacation, and I'm going to watch the store for him while he's gone.
That's ridiculous. No, this can't be true. Is this true?
Oh, it's true. And it's not going to be the same around here anymore.
You're telling me. I mean, I come in here all the time, and Alan makes my porridge, always. I just can't, like, stroll in here and have some lady who's not Alan make my porridge. Know how feelings, what was your name again?
Natalie.
But, I'm just very, you know, particular about my porridge.
I understand. Yeah. I love porridge, too.
You love porridge?
Oh, yeah, it's my absolute favorite. I make it all the time.
You do? Well, just out of curiosity, how do you make your porridge?
I bet it's not like Alan's.
Well, I take the porridge, and first I put in...
Raisins, huh? Just like Alan?
Nope. Nuts.
Nuts? That's nuts! Alan never puts in nuts.
Don't panic. I'll go get Alan.
Wait. Hold on a second, Big Bird. I'm intrigued. Continue, please, Natalie.
Well, then, yeah. I put in...
Let me guess. Cinnamon, white?
Nope. Peaches.
Peaches. Now, that's certainly different.
Let me go get Alan.
Hold on, Big Bird. While peaches are a very un-Alan-like approach, they are intriguing.
Well, next, I put in...
Oh, I know. Maple syrup, white, huh? Just like Alan.
No honey.
Ha, 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 ha. Honey?
Don't worry. Alan will know what to do.
Wait a minute. No need, Big Bird. Natalie's putting in honey. I'm a bale. Bales love honey. Oh, boy. You know, Natalie, I would really love to, you know, like, try that porridge.
Well, here you go.
Ooh. Hmm.
So, is it any good, baby bear?
It's not good, Big Bode.
I didn't think so. I'll go get Alan.
It's great! Oh, man. Oh, my taste buds are going crazy. They're like experiencing extreme taste sensations. Natalie, you can make my porridge anytime. Oh, man, this is good. Oh, boy. Oh, it's delicious. Thank you.
You know, I like working here.
Oh, well, does that mean that you're gonna take the job?
I think so.
Oh.
What's wrong?
Well, every day I come into Hooper's store and I see Alan. Now, next week I want to come in here and Alan's not going to be here at all.
It's hard sometimes when things change, huh, Big Bird?
Oh, I'll say. I don't like change.
Any kind of change?
Uh-uh. Do you?
I sure do.
Yeah.
The leaves grow green in summertime, beautiful to behold. But they're all so lovely in autumn's wind, changing to red and gold. Things change, yes, they change, though different and new. Change can be good too.
Well, maybe sometimes.
Snowflakes fall in winter time. They dance and simmer and glow. And the world's a sparkly wonderland, changed by blankets of snow. Things change, yes, they change, though
I guess I like some change.
From winter, spring, to summer and fall, the changes never end. But the sweetest change in life may be when we find and we make a new friend.
Things change, yes, they change. Though different and new, change can be good too. Change can be good too.
I guess change doesn't have to be bad.
Well, Natalie, what do you think? You gonna take the job?
What do you think, Big Bird?
Oh, well, I think I'm really going to miss Alan. But I'm going to like getting to know you, Natalie.
Oh, thanks, Big Bird. Alan, I'll take the job.
Fantastic. When can you start?
How about right now?
Yeah.
Great. You know what? I'm going to go finish packing for my vacation, and I will see you both when I get back.
Bye, Alan. Bye.
Aloha.
Aloha.
Hey, Big Bird.
Hmm?
How about a birdseed milkshake?
Oh, well, how do you make it?
With birdseed.
That's just how I like it.
Great.
I think this is the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Important, you're important. Anybody can see. Important, you're important. You mean a lot to me. If you're going for a roller skate, if your hook needs a little bait, if your dog don't wanna sit, or you're sleepy just a little bit, I'll be there most certainly. 'Cause you're important. You're important to me. Important, you're important. Anybody can see. Important, you're important. a lot to me. If your favorite tooth came loose, if you can't open up your juice, if there's no wind for your kite, or your haircut didn't turn out right, I'll be there sure as can be, 'cause you're important. You're important to me. Important, you're important. Anybody can see. Important, you're important. You mean a lot to me. You mean a lot to me. You mean a lot to me.
Hello there, me Cookie Monster. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And me here to pick letter of day. And letter of day inside cookie jar here. Oh boy, oh boy, let's see what we got there. Oh boy, me love to run finger through alphabet. Ah, come on, come on. Oh, me got a good day. What is letter of day? Oh boy, this is so exciting. Me so nervous. Come on to pop a letter of day. Oh, letter D. Ha ha. Today letter is letter D. Now, how we know? Well, let's test. Sound like letter D? D, D, D. Let's see, it smell like letter D? Oh yeah, definitely smell like letter D. Well, if it tastes like letter D, then it would taste delicious or delectable. Okay, here we go. Don't. D starts don't. Yeah, you know what it's saying to me? It's saying, letter of day, too important to eat. Oh no, me no can eat D. It's too important in alphabet. Oh, me must remember, no eat D, no eat D. Oh, how me remember that? Me no, me make sign to help me focus. That's it. Me make sign. Okay. Let's see. Okay. Me make sign. Yeah. Okay. There. Sign. Say, don't. Don't. Let's read, okay? Don't. Start with D. Don't. Mean don't eat cookie, right? Don't. Don't. What you doing? And look at sign. Sign say, don't eat cookie. Why, you no can read, hand? Oh, boy. Okay, me got to concentrate. Don't eat cookie.
D. D. There's a big yellow D in that wagon. D is for dark. D.
Don't. That means don't eat letter of day. Even though this one delicious letter D. Oh, me going crazy. Okay, don't. What me doing? Me no want to eat that. Me want to eat that. Wait a minute. Wait, sign look different. Me better read it now. Do. Sign saying do eat letter. Kawabunga. Delightful.
Who's that planting veggies in the backyard plot?
Dad, D-A-D, Dad.
Who showed me how to dribble and to shoot my shot?
Dad, D-A-D, Dad. Dad, D-A-D, Dad.
And who's the one who taught me how to ride my bike?
Dad, D-A-D, Dad.
Yeah, Dad!
the packing doing, dear?
Just about done.
Oh, good. Well, Jimmy, tomorrow's the big day. We're moving to a new house.
I don't want to move. Everything is going to change, and I want things to stay just the way they are.
Dear, now, we understand how you feel, but everything's gonna be just fine, you'll see.
Sure.
Oh, try to get some sleep, honey. Good night.
Night, Mom.
Good night, Jimmy.
Night, Dad.
Yo, Bucky!
Huh?
You say you're feeling bad because you have to move? Gonna have a new room? And you're gonna miss your old room?
Yeah.
And you're not gonna know anybody? And you're gonna have to make all new friends? And you're gonna miss all your old friends? Is that what's troubling you, Bunky?
Jimmy.
Is that what's troubling you, Bunky? Jimmy?
Yeah.
Well, you can stop your worrying. Just remember, things are always changing, but don't be sad and blue. Change can make you happy, cause it brings you something new. Your caterpillar's all wrapped up and he won't tell you why. Inside his sack, he's changing. Soon he'll be a butterfly. And you know it doesn't matter if you lost your polywogs. They really didn't disappear. They all changed into frogs. Hey, things are always changing, but don't be sad and blue. Change can make you happy, cause it brings you something new. Sing it! Things are always changing, but don't be sad and blue. Change can make you happy, cause it brings you something new. Yeah, not much stays just like it was, as that old clock keeps ticking. For every little egg you lose, you could get back a chicken. And if you plant an acorn and wait a year or three, then turn around and look again, you just might find a tree. Hey, things are always changing, but don't be sad and blue. Change can make you happy, cause it brings you something new. Sing it! Things are always changing, but don't be sad and blue. Change can make you happy, cause it brings you something new. The seasons keep on changing too. The summer turns to fall. No more swimming, no more picnics, but we get to play football. Hey, things are always changing, but don't be sad and blue. Change can make you happy, cause it brings you something new. Everybody!
Things are always changing, but don't be sad and blue. Change can make you happy, cause it brings you something new.
Hey! So how you feeling?
Great, Bunky.
That's hoots.
Are you all right, dear?
Yes, Ma.
Are you sure, son?
Yes. Now, please let me get to sleep. We're moving tomorrow.
Oh, hi. I'm cleaning up around my nest. Yeah, I just have to put this stuff away in my toy box, and everything will be as neat as...
It's time to play Journey to Ernie, where Ernie hides and Big Bird seeks.
Oh, boy. Journey to Ernie. Oh, I wonder where Ernie's going to hide today.
You'll see. Ducky paddle.
Whoa. Quick, count to 10, and no peeking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ready or not, here we come. Whoa. I have a feeling we're not on Sesame Street anymore. In fact, I know we're not. We're at the beach. I wonder where Ernie could be hiding.
This is WSAND coming to you live from the beach. When it comes to the beach, we know where it's at.
Do you know where Ernie's at?
No, but we can give you a clue. He's hiding under something.
He's hiding under something. Let's go look. See anything? Aha. There's somebody under that beach towel. I'll bet it's Ernie. Come out from under that towel, Ernie. We got you. Oh, you're not Ernie.
No, but don't be crabby about it.
Oh, where could that Ernie be?
Don't throw in the towel, because here's another clue. He's hiding under something and over something.
under, and over?
How does he do that?
Very carefully! Now keep looking!
Okay. Ernie is under something and over something. Look! That hammock is hanging under the palm trees and over that beach ball. That's it! Ernie must be in the hammock. Found you, Ernie. Come on out. Oh, no, it's a seal.
You're barking up the wrong tree.
Come on. Ernie must be here somewhere.
Ba-do-be-da, ba-do-be-da.
Excuse me. Did you see Ernie?
Ernie! Yeah!
Which way did he go?
That way.
Let's keep looking. I don't see Ernie anywhere, do you? What could he be hiding under and over?
Don't give up the ship, cuz here's another clue! He's hiding under something, and over something, and in something!
Under, over, in something? How can he do that? Wait, that sounded like Ernie's laugh. Ah, it's coming from the water. That's it! Ernie's under the water and in a submarine. But what are you over, Ernie?
I'm over a dolphin named Charlie. Come on up here, Charlie. Woo.
We found him! We found Ernie!
Ta-da! Thanks, Charlie.
It's Ernie.
It's me.
I'd know you anywhere. The when you laugh, that Ernie shirt and hair. The squeaking of your ducky tells us you're the one.
Ooh.
We found him, we found him. La, 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 la. Our journey to Ernie is done.
Wait till you see where I hide next time.
Ooh.
Right, you too, you little ducky.
Oh, doing the pigeon. Doing the cuckoo pigeon. Doing the little smidge. Hey, Ernie.
Hi, Bert.
What are you doing?
Oh, well, I'm playing house, Bert.
Oh, well, you're playing house. Who are you pretending to be?
Well, I think you should guess, Bert. Look, watch this. Watch this.
Oh, excellent.
Mm, thank you.
Yeah, okay, well, I'll guess. Ernie, are you pretending to be, well, I don't know, the daddy cooking dinner? Yeah.
Good guess, Bert.
Yeah, good.
But wrong. I'm not pretending to be the daddy cooking dinner. Guess again.
Oh, okay. How about are you pretending to be the brother, yeah, washing the pots and pans?
Nope, not the brother, Bert.
Oh. Mm-hmm. You're not the mommy, are you?
No, Bert, I'm not the mommy, Bert.
Oh.
Come on, concentrate.
Okay, I'll concentrate. You are the baby?
Not the baby either.
Mm. Let me see. The grandfather?
Nope.
The nephew?
Uh-uh.
The second cousin once removed?
Nope.
I give up. I mean, those are all the people I can think of in a family. If you're playing house, then who are you?
I'm the stove, Bert.
The stove?
Mm-hmm. Don't, careful, Bert. Stove's hot. Don't burn yourself.
Oh, easy does it. Easy there. Oh, hello there. It is I, your furry blue world traveler, Grover. And I just flew this kite all the way back from Malaysia, which is very far away. Sorry, this kite has a mind of its own. Did you know that you can make your own kite? Yes, it is true. That is what they do in Malaysia. And I learned how to do it too. Watch this. Whoa! In Malaysia, there is a place called Kelantan.
where they make the most beautiful kites. They start with bamboo sticks, which are very flexible. This is Arif. He is learning to make a kite for the very first time. They tie the bamboo sticks together with string. Did you know that their word for kite is wow? Wow, that is some wow! Arif is finishing the framework, but his kite is not ready to fly yet. Oh, why not? We are all waiting for the moment of takeoff. It needs some colorful paper, like you see here. So they glue the paper onto the framework. You have to be very careful not to glue your cute little fingers to the paper. Then, after a few finishing touches, the kite is ready. Is it not beautiful? Is it not adorable? Is it not going to fly already? Look at that! It is flying! Arif is flying a kite that he made himself! Oh, watch out! It is going to crash! Ah, whew! Isn't kite flying fun? Whew! That was a close one! Kite flying can be fun when your kite cooperates with you, that is. Whoa! Stringing me along. Now I know why they call kites wow.
Wow!
Oh,
ouch! Ouch!
That is one strong kite. Good thing I did not make it any bigger.
And welcome to my castle. I am the Count Von Count. Yes, and now it is time for one of my very favorite things in the whole wide world. Do you know what that is? Right. It's time for the number of the day. Ooh, that sounds so nice. I'll say it twice. The number of the day. Yes. Oh, boy. I wonder what the number of the day could be. Let's find out, shall we? One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Oh, what will the number be? Four.
Four.
Five.
Five.
Six.
Six.
Seven.
Seven.
Eight.
Eight.
I can hardly wait. Nine.
Nine.
Ten.
Ten.
When? 11.
11.
12.
12.
13.
13.
14.
14.
15.
15.
16.
16.
17.
17.
Nice.
Here's my hand.
Esta es mi mano. And this is my hand.
And we're counting to 17.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
That's my little brother's hand.
16. 17. Yay!
Yeah. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do bugs get from one place to another?
Dorothy, this is a caterpillar, and this is how it crawls. See?
Dorothy, this is a pajori ant, and the ant walks around like this.
Dorothy, a grasshopper is a kind of bug. A grasshopper hops like this.
Thank you, kids. Thank you, Dorothy. Now Elmo's going to ask a baby. Hello, baby. Hello, hello, hello. Oh, baby, how do bugs get from one place to the other? Thank you, baby. Snug as a bug in a rug. Sit up really fast, Dorothy. Wow, Dorothy's good. And now...
Elmo has mail.
Oh, boy, oh, boy. Oh, thanks, computer. Little help, Mouse. Thank you. Oh, Elmo's friend Prairie Don sent Elmo an email.
Hello, Elmo. I have a favorite nursery rhyme about a bug. It is called Little Miss Muffet, and it goes like this. Little Miss Muffet sat on a tuffet, eating her curds and whey. Yum, curds and whey. Along came a spider that sat down beside her and frightened Miss Muffet away.
Hey, hey, hey!
Curds and whey?
Well, I prefer yogurt and granola, but that'll do.
Okay. See you later, Elmo!
Bye-bye!
Oh, thanks for the message, computer! See you soon! And now, Elmo has a question for you! Oh, there he is! How many legs on this... Dorothy, what is it again? Oh, okay, yeah. A centipede, thanks. Let's count the legs on the centipede and see.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
We didn't finish counting your legs. Oh, well. Great counting, everybody. That centipede must be in a hurry to get home. Oh, that makes someone wonder, where do bugs live? Let's find out. Oh, it sounds like a bug living in the drawer. Is there any bugs in there? Where do spiders live? An ice cream cone? A cloud? Or a web.
A web.
Yeah, spiders live in a web. Where do ants live? A shoe? The moon? Or the ground?
The ground.
Where do bees live? A hive? A birthday cake? Or a bonnet?
A hive.
Bees live in hives. Where do twitter bugs live? A computer, a bowl of spaghetti, or Ernie's window box.
Ernie's window box.
Yeah, the twiddle bugs live in Ernie's window box.
Oh, I wonder what the twiddle bugs are up to today. Hark, do I hear singing?
Bugs. Oh, so does his friend Charisma. She likes to look at them in her backyard. She told Elmo all about it.
I like to go into my backyard and look at all the bugs there. I love bugs. When I turn over a rock, I see lots of bugs. Crickets, centipedes. And those roly-poly bugs are called sow bugs. You have to look on leaves to find caterpillars. They can be hard to find, but I always find one. Some caterpillars turn into butterflies and moths. They're fun to follow. There are lots of ants in our backyard, and they're always going someplace. I stay away from the bees. They can sting, and that hurts. Grasshoppers are fun to watch. They hop, and they fly. And if you take the bark off an old log, you might see some grubs. Grubs are bugs. Ladybugs are my favorite bug. They are very friendly. Bugs are the best. I love them.
Wow. Ladybugs really are friendly.
What's that?
Oh, Ladybug has to go to a picnic? Okay. Fly away. Oh. Bye. Wow. You know, Elmo wants to learn more about bugs. How can Elmo learn more? Oh, yeah! Elmo can watch the Bug Channel on this Grasshopper TV bug.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. The bugs want to watch the Bug Channel, too. Okay, go ahead. Turn yourself on, TV.
The Bug Channel, crawling into your home. And now, it's time for the Bug Lady.
Hi there, I'm the Bug Lady. I love bugs. You know what my favorite bug is? Ants! Look at those cute little ants. Do they have uncles? Ha, ha, ha. I have a great ant song that I'm going to teach you now, and we can all sing it. And you can march to it, too, like this. It's a marching song. And you sing hurrah. Let me hear it. Hurrah! Hurrah! Great. Everybody ready? Here we go! The ants go marching one by one. Hurrah! Hurrah! The ants go marching one by one. Hurrah! Hurrah! The ants go marching one by one. The little one stops to suck his thumb, and they all go marching down into the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, boom, boom. The ants go marching two by two. Hurrah! Go marching two by two, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching two by two. The little one stops to tie his shoe, and they all go marching down into the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, boom, boom. The ants go marching three by three, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching three by three, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching three by three. The little one stops to climb a tree, and they all go marching down into the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 boom! That was great. Now I'm gonna march inside and get out of the rain. Boom, boom, boom!
Boom, 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 boom! Wait, wait, Chibi! Elmo wants to know more about bugs.
Oh.
Don't you? How can we find out more?
Well, let me tell you. I know. I can tell you.
Oh, yeah! Elmo can talk to bugs. Go ahead.
Yeah. Okay, let me tell you about me.
No, one at a time, Bugs. Elmo can't understand you. What's that fly?
Bugs can do many things.
Really? Well, like what?
Fly.
Oh, yeah. Flies fly a lot.
And spiders spin webs.
Elmo likes looking at spider webs.
Yeah.
Oh, look! Oh, Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a spider spinning a web. Whee! Elmo's worldwide web. Whee!
turned out the light?
Fireflies make a light.
Oh, Elmo is the light.
Bees make honey.
How sweet it is.
Story, Slimy. Now, let's see. The Adventures of Trash Gordon, Chapter 538.
When we last left our hero, Trash Gordon, he was stranded on the planet Gorgonzola, surrounded by the dreadfully smelly, awfully pungent, stinky cheese guys. Things didn't look good for Trash. They didn't smell too good either. When all of a sudden, Trash Gordon let out a heroic sneeze. Which sent the stinky cheese guys hurtling and stinking through space. Trash laughed and said heroically,
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letter D and by the number 17.
Little fella. That's enough excitement for one day. Now off to sleep. We'll have another chapter tomorrow. Rotten dreams. Hey, you didn't see me tuck him in. Now, scram, huh?